Hi, this video is about how to build a community website using BuddyPress. Do you want to be able to build a community similar to Facebook? Do you want members to be able to register and interact with each other in a public and private setting?
Hey, I'm Drost, DrostDesigns.com.
Here's some popular community websites that are using BuddyPress. Here are the steps for building a community website. Number one, define your purpose and goals. Many website owners build a site without clarifying its true purpose and goals. For example, the purpose of a church website could be to increase membership, keep track of upcoming events, and accept online donations. Number two, install WordPress. One thing to keep in mind here for installing WordPress to use with BuddyPress is that it should be installed manually via FTP. Don't use the web hosting scripts such as Fantastico and Softalicious. BuddyPress doesn't work when you install WordPress in its own directory. Instead, place it in the root directory. For more information on how to do that, go to my complete guide on installing BuddyPress by visiting this website. Next is the BuddyPress plugin installation. To do that, simply go to your plugins, dashboard plugins in your WordPress site, then search for the plugin and install and activate the plugin. Then you also want to go to themes after you've done that and install the BuddyPress default theme. Next, you got to configure the BuddyPress components. So if you go down to settings BuddyPress, you'll see here all the components. Next, you got to configure the BuddyPress pages. Let's say you want register to be accessed on a page called registration. You simply create a blank page titled registration first by going to pages, add new, and create the registration page and then save it. Next, you want to configure the BuddyPress settings. So you go to settings, and here you can see that you checked all the boxes on the main settings, profile settings. Next, you want to set up the profile fields. So you go to users, profile fields, and here you can add a new field that's relevant to the purpose of your social network. Next step is that you can create a customized menu. You simply go to your dashboard, appearance, menus, and as you can see, I've assigned a menu here where you can save the menu. The last step is to install the calendar events plugin. Here's an example of the events plugin displayed on the website.
And now I'd like to invite you to download my free report, 21 ways to promote your blog post that you probably wish you knew. Click the box above or visit the link in the description below this video. Thanks for watching.